coming in. Going up against Yoda Cage, sitting on winner's side. This will be Codename Bears 293 Grand Finals coming at you. Starting off on small battlefield. And again, just because that Mercury said that Byleth can do everything Joker can, but with a lot more damaging tool set out of the gate, it's just very much out of the gate in Yoda Cage's face. So, but right now, Yoda Cage finding those little chip moments where he can rack up the damage. He does find himself sitting very narrowly in terms of damages in control here. But that'll absolutely do it. Especially with small battlefield in its blast zones. First stock going the way of Morton and Yoda Cage. Mercury trying to find some purchase on him, but again, I mentioned before how Bowser Jr. is volatile, not only in his attack options, but just his movement too. He can throw out the clown card any moment, and it's just really, really a pester. Just try to peg him down, let alone to break out of some of his combos. Morton again, just so quick. You saw him on that stage again. Mercury got the kill there, but you saw him so quick that just, you know, starting to walk away from that platform to quickly turning around and just being on top of Mercury. Bowser Jr. has some speed on him. So we'll see how Mercury climbs back 2-2. Needs to find some combos of his own, and that's maybe something that he starts to lose when he does drift more towards Byleth instead of Joker. Obviously, Joker is combo city, but Byleth just, you know, he has one or two combos at most, starting off with a nair or with a grab, really, or the up B on stage. But not a whole lot to speak of after that point. Finally gets the down air, though. Another factor is once you get that damage up, you can finally get those clincher hits that he needs. And he's absolutely found his path forward right now, because he has swung this right back around in his favor. Mercury looking to claim the first round after, at least first interactions-wise, going down to Yoda Cage. But Yoda Cage, again, watch those jabs. You always know, when you're sitting around 100 on the left or right side of the stage, he will always, nearly always, go for that jab. Either that or down smash. And he was chipped out, but because he pursued, Byleth got back. He might have had a, he might have been able to get back, but still, I would have just let him potentially lose instead of just giving him the full okay there. And because of that, Mercury has new life on these final stocks. 95 gets the up smash in, and he has to land, uses the clown card to get around it. Trying to trap him with a bomb. Probably thought that Mercury was going to try and land on him, so maybe he thought he could exchange himself with the bomb there, but Yoda Cage still on stage. Still has that locked down, and he does drift back on! Not going to get the round claim there, even though we saw the sparks fly out from the hit. Great DI from Yoda Cage to survive that. You know, obviously, very finicky, the zoom in and the splash of that that final hit graphic there. But still, major props for him to not, I mean, just even bounce on stage, let alone skirt off to the side of, potentially skirt off to the side of small battlefield and potentially need to tech. Last hit here, both 160, 170 range. Have to be so careful. These are just gods going back and forth, getting hit by the cannonball. This sneaky cannonball off screen will be the deciding factor. Yoda Cage again, first on top in those early interactions, and it paid off for him in the end. Mercury swung it around to make it last stock situation. But Yoda Cage, being on winner's side, finds every value of getting those wins. Mercury obviously needs more of them, and he finds value in them too, but Yoda Cage wanted to get an early night here. He's going to cherish every win that he gets, especially against Mercury. Again, someone who can quickly adapt. So we'll see how he learned, being a lot more in the face of Bowser Jr. and Yoda Cage. But he did need a combo for it. He has to be very careful. Again, I don't think the in-your-face option was the wrong pick. I think he just has to be careful not to overcommit to that option. Because he did do a couple landing nairs, but it was just down to the third one where Yoda just sat in the shield and was able to get a combo off it. And again, same story. Got to avoid the Mecha Koopa there. He does. But same story, yeah. First interactions. A little slower this time around, but going the way Yoda Cage just misses the up B. Maybe looking for an air dodge, but he did not come out either in time or at all. And very quickly, even though he had commanded control, Yoda Cage lets one slip by and gets the advantage to Mercury this time around. But at 136, the damage is done. We had to find the hit that'll do it, though. But in the meantime, Mercury can run. But running is not going to do a whole lot when you have to run against the car. Great job for Yoda Cage to finally claim that stock. And all he needs, again, is one combo, and he's right back in it. Mercury not giving him that chance, trying to go in with that leading nair to stifle out any of those options. Bowser Jr. finally getting a couple of up airs and then the tried and true up B back air. Looking for it here. Great little pacing back and forth for Mercury. Finding that back air hit. Very nice. And again, it was given to him a little bit by Yoda Cage, but Mercury is still holding on to it. Knows how to hold on to advantages and find disadvantages as well. But so does Yoda Cage. Gotta be careful of that landing there from Byleth. But Yoda Cage heavily pursuing, chips him out too far away. And again, another decisive factor going forward is that tether grab. Whether it be Joker or Byleth, all you need is one little gimp move from Bowser Jr., and that is an easy stop claim for him. So far, tacking on damage, but still running like he is the one on top. Mercury, recognizing the situation, knows that he can't let Yoda Cage go up 2-0 and have it come down to potential final round so early tonight. Gets the lash on the stage, but quick coverage from Yoda and a spin out off stage. You're not safe on, you're not safe off. And Yoda Cage is one win away from claiming CNB 293. But again, Mercury, one who can quickly adapt, one who has so many of downloading matchups. Will we see the swap back to Joker, and will he have accrued enough knowledge? Now, Byleth being the pick. All right, do or die time for Mercury. We'll see how it unfolds. Will we see, again, the not impossible, but very rarely seen 3-0 swing to bring Mercury into this, right back into this and get the reset? Or can we call it at all an early night tonight and get Yoda Cage again wearing that crown? See how it happens here. Round three. Using a lot more risky options. He did rack up enough damage there in those early interactions, so I did see why Mercury went for the side B in retrospect. But a very, very nice conversion of a little custom combo there. We'll give Yoda Cage a resounding command. But Mecha Koopa gonna stifle him out in terms of ledge guard situation, knocked him a little too far left. And Mercury able to get back relatively cleanly. Took about maybe 10 damage getting back, but jab from across the stage, not gonna do it. Yoda Cage again sitting pretty, has to shield double time for the Mecha Koopa cannonball combo. And again, Mercury in that pressure situation. Great tech, by the way, as he was low. And again, deciding factor is going to be that stage control, as Yoda Cage does get that first stock claim, 123. We don't have to question if Joker can do it. Byleth absolutely can, so Mercury can absolutely make this a 2-2, basically all even game, and he does so. Great spot dodge too to avoid the grab. Has Yoda off stage. A little bit of a kamikaze too, and just piling on the damage. We see Mercury finding a lot more comfort, but all you need is a jab combo. combo, as if it's not just one move. But still, relying on it and more is Yoda Cage. He is one stock away from claiming 293. Mercury again, 105 damage tack on. He knows he can do it with Byleth. He just has to find the interaction, but no! Unfortunately, what we know as the Yoda Cage special comes out, and unfortunate SD makes it all even without Mercury's input. And Mercury might have just found new life off of that. Playing a little bit more of a footsie game, trying to be a little more back and forth with his inputs, a little more questionable when he's going to move in. But that unforeseen Mecha Koopa all the way off to the right, going to force him off stage, looking for the charge up smash. Great wait for Mercury, but Yoda Cage just recognizing, hey, you're on ledge, I'm gonna jab, like I said before. And he's at that 100 mark, looking for up smash, not going to take. Looking for the beat out with the Mecha Koopa again. No, Mercury back in mid. But he definitely has the mount to climb, up smash, try to shoot Yoda Cage, claiming it all. 1, 2, 3, unchallenged. Yoda Cage has been unleashed tonight at Codename Bears 293. He is your champion tonight. Man, it was a slog. It was an uphill battle for him. Just, yes, I will. yeah, my throat is actually getting a little sore, so it's going to be a quick shout-out for me. So props again to Yoda Cage for claiming 293 tonight. If you guys want to show what you guys are worth in this game, you can come down to a Codename Bears, or very quickly, we have the Arcadian coming up. If you're not feeling all these PR players, PR is not allowed, out-of-state PR not allowed, or it's also up to the discretion of Rose Calamity if you're a very good player. Not allowed as well. So new players, come on out October 23rd, if I remember correctly. Come check that out. I've been Yoda Cage. He's been Yoda Cage. I've been Mini Boss. I'm tired. I was about to say right after that. Yeah, no, I want to be Yoda Cage. He got the money tonight. That's my envy. But yeah, I'm Mini Boss. I've been your commentator for tonight. Thank you guys for watching. We'll see you at 294. Thanks, guys. Oh, God.
Whoa.
Go!
quarter. not battle. Whoa. Portal.
Go! Hey! Two, one, go! Two, one, go! God, it's still recording.